What's up, Instagram? What's up, face Instagram right now? How we doing? So we're gonna get started. What's up, Facebook? I don't own the rights to this. What's up, Instagram? Y'all thought I wasn't gonna come on tonight? It's kinda late for y'all.
Business meeting.
So we had meetings today. It's been a little busy, a little hectic. We had soccer practice with the boys. We had business meeting today. We had a lot of stuff going on with the marriage porn site, actually. It's actually expanding. It's great. It's been a blessing, guys. Glad you tuned in for this Monday. And remember, I don't own the rights to this music. Just so that we don't get cut off, I don't own the rights to this music, okay? But I got a few announcements over some things I want to go over. If you looked at the story, we can, we'll talk about, we got actually the program. It's the Empowerment Marriage Program that's going to be starting up in May 15th. That's when it's launched. All right. 6 step to empowering your marriage. Right. So we got that going on. We got a lot of links going on right now. You can check out our YouTube, which just to be played back on YouTube if you miss any of this. We got a YouTube page going on. That's popping. We got a lot of people starting to tune into the YouTube. We got a lot of footage on there. You can also go to the Marriage Porn Instagram, which I'm live on there right now. I stopped doing the Instagram. Anybody that's on my Facebook, I stopped doing the live Instagram on my feed. And I actually put it on the marriage porn. So you got to go to marriage.p.o.r.o.n on Instagram to catch this footage. Anybody that's on my Facebook that catches us on Instagram, on my Instagram. So, like I said, I don't own the rights to this song. I put this You Make Me Better on because I thought about the topic a little bit. This topic right here, Men's Talk Monday, what does self-care looks like for us, right? What self-care looks like for us fellas, right? And I ain't gonna be too long because I know it's late. I know if you're on the East Coast, you might gotta get up and go make those donuts, those zeros, right? In the morning. So I'm gonna keep you guys just short and brief. But I want to go over a few things that I like to talk about. Maybe you could go ahead and get us down on the volume on that right there. But yeah. Hey, matter of fact, where anybody chiming in, let me know where you're chiming in from. Let me know where you're coming in from, where you viewing us from, Matt. Unless, there we go. All right, all right. So just put in the comments, chats, anything. But again, the topic is, what does self-care look like for us fellas, right? So I had a few notes and stuff like that. And I'm going to elaborate a little bit on this. So when I think about self-care for us fellas, right? I think about, basically, can you pause it? So when I think about self-care for us fellas, I think about stuff like, and this is crazy how I think about self-care for us dudes, but I think about compared to how a woman look at self-care, you know. I think a woman look at self-care as more of a pampering type of thing, you know, where they pamper themselves and they can relax, which I'm not saying us fellas, we can't do that as well, but I say, maybe our pampering is going to the barbershop. That's one of our self-cares as just far as pampering ourselves. maybe a massage, going to get a massage, right? A massage, that might be, you know, self-care. Far as us fellas, you know, that I could think about. But when I just came along with a list of things and I thought about what would self-care kind of look like just for me in particular, since I'm talking about this, one of the things is building something. Building something, right? All right. So building something with my hands or working on a project, I'm thinking to myself, that's one of the things. And then also another self-care that we can look at is also working out. I know a lot of fellas that go to the gym and they work out, so I see that as a sign of self-care for us fellas, right? Working out. I put massage, you know, that's us pampering ourselves. Because like I said, I see when it comes to self-care with women, I think it's more pampering themselves compared to us fellas. I don't think we really pamper ourselves besides like a massage, maybe a pedicure, you know, or going to the barbershop or something like that. Also put in a guy's night out, you know, hanging out with the guys. That's one of the things, you know. Maybe, what about this? Self-care for us fellas, what it look like for us. And this is crazy that I put this, but I know this is true right here. This is crazy, but I know I put this. Being alone. You just want to be by yourself. Just want to be by yourself. That's part of us having our man self, our manly self-care. Also, reading. Reading, and that's kind of more in the isolation box, you know, when you can read, and that's self-care, and I think that's a good thing far as us men, what we can do far as self-care and how we look at self-care for us men. And shopping. Us fellas, yes, we like to shop. We like to go get nice things, especially I know some of my homeboys, they are really big shoe fanatics. So, you know, shopping for shoes or shopping for colognes, shopping just for clothes in general, or shopping for watches, you know, things like that. Maybe jewelry, necklace, chains, maybe cars, shopping for cars, shopping for houses, you know. But I'm putting this in the category of self-care, if you can understand where I'm coming from. I'm putting this in a category of self-care. I put this one because I put racing. And the only reason I put racing because I'm just putting it in more of a like competitive form for us fellas to have self-care, you know. And then I put eating. Us fellas, I think self-care to us is eating different types of food or whatever we like to eat. We consider that self-care. And as well as eating, laughter. Being able to laugh, have fun, go to a lounge or a sports bar, go to a game or a concert, you know. So when I started looking at self-care for us fellas, I'm starting to think of this right here. Majority of our self-care as men and as fellas is, I think it's more mental than physical, you know. I think when it comes to us men being in the household and stuff like that, I feel that self-care comes in more of a mental form than a physical form compared to women, you know. Because if you look at when a woman want to do self-care, it's more like, you know, long bubble baths or massages or relaxing or getting her hair done or getting her pedicure or, you know, also reading. Some of these things we can coincide with, you know, with our wives, because this is a marriage call, with our wives or our special someone. we can coincide with these self-care. But the question is, do you want to do your self-care alone, or you do want to do it with your partner? And I'm going to tell you, just be honest with me, myself, some stuff, majority of the things, I would rather do alone, you know? And that's the thing that you got to talk to your partner about your self-care as a man. You got to tell your wife, you know, I want time out for me. And there's nothing wrong with telling her you want time out for you, but how do you want time out for you? Do you want time out for you to go to a lounge and just clear your mind, get some few drinks, or just, you know, even just relax, listen to some good music, some vibing music, if she's not into that? Or going to a sports bar and just having a conversation with a random, you know, random fella, somebody that's at the bar, who's sitting at the bar, and you just spark up a random conversation about life. Maybe even it can be political, or it can be religious, or it can be financial, you know. So I feel like with us men, more of these conversations that we have for self-care comes in more of a mental form than a physical form. And while I put the number one thing with me was building something, right? Because I feel like for me, and I'm just talking for me in general, I feel like when I'm doing something like is building something or putting something together, even though I'm focused on that project, I think my mind can multitask to be somewhere else to release stress from the world problems or any problems that I'm going through, you know, in life. So I like to work with my hands. So if I'm building something, then I'm not thinking about stress, and it's also like a stress reliever as well, far as my self-care as a man. You get what I'm saying? I don't have to be working on a real in-deep project, or if I am working in a real in-deep project, I can have it where I'm still focused on that project, but my mind is somewhere else where I'm still having that self-care with myself. Go back to working out. I think working out is one of the number one self-care that we can do as fellas. It's just stay working out, staying on top of your game, you know, staying fit, being physical, just getting that stamina, agility back into your system. I think me, when I get on like a treadmill, elliptical machine, and I got the music pumping in my ear, it's like, it's hard at first. You know, it's hard when you first start getting back into the working out mode and you're on the treadmill, and it's hard. But it's like, when you catch that second wind, you catch that second wind while you're on that treadmill or that elliptical machine, or you just running in period, it's like you can run for days. Like, somebody really can have to pull you and stop running, because not only your mind is on a mental race, but your mind is just different. It's on a different wave function. Like, if you get into that workout zone, and I know if you don't work out, I understand you don't understand where I'm coming out from, but if you get into that workout zone, and for most of us fellas, I know we play sports, you know what in the zone is. In the zone mean, like, nobody can stop you from what you're doing. Nobody can, you know what I'm saying, stop your progression from where you're going or what you're thinking about. So I think when we work out, we're thinking about other business plans, other ideas, other financial goals, family life. It's a whole bunch of things that come into this category while you're working out and you're on the treadmill and the elliptical machines. And then you have that song that comes up in your earbud that makes you go harder, or makes you think you why you should be grinding a little bit harder than what you grinding. You know, you got that song that come up on your random playlist, and it just motivates you even more to the next level, and you just ready to take on the world. And I think that's a good thing, and I think that's a major part of us having self-care awareness, far as us men, because we don't really look at self-care in that aspect. We don't look at self-care. We look at it as, oh, I'm going to work out to get in shape or whatever. But that, I feel that's a form of self-care for us fellas. And so massages, right? I think massage is also a form of self-care, which, you know, women get massages, we get massages, and different types of massages is a good form of self-care. Actually, I wanted to try this. I haven't tried it yet. I want to do acupuncture. I would like to really try that to see how that works. But again, a massage, this goes back to also the mental more than physical, you know. And I think the reason why our self-care is more mental than physical, because we're doing a lot of physical things throughout the day, right? We're doing a lot of physical things throughout today to make sure everything's running right and going smoothly throughout our day. You know, a lot of our tasks usually inject a lot of physical stuff that we have to do on a daily basis. You know, just being the man of the house, you know, you're going to do something physical around your house if you're the man of your house and get it done, right? Or something that's got to be done, or somebody needs help with something that's got to be done, right? God's night out. Is that self-care? I think so. I think God's night out is great because those are the times that you can have those conversations that you really can't have with nobody. If it's with the boys or with some of your mentors or any friends that you come around that you really trust with conversation, I feel that God's night out is a great thing because I think that's a mental release as well. A lot of conversations, a lot of things you want to talk about that you can't talk about with your wife. You want to talk about that she won't be able to relate because she's not a man. So the things that you want her to be able to relate, she can't relate. But you got other fellas that can relate to the topics. And just like I have these men's calls on Monday, these are topics that us fellas, we can relate to. And if you want, you can have your wife actually watch these replays about what we go through as men and how we deal with our different types of self-care. You know, being alone, I'll put a star by that one. Being alone is really one of the things. And it was crazy because before, even at times when I was married, my wife would actually say, and like I said, we going through this thing together, you know what I'm saying? My wife would say, what do you want for your birthday? And I was like, just to be alone. And she's like, you don't want to be with the family and stuff like that, with the kids. I'm like, no, I just want to be alone. And she probably didn't understand that, right? And so the reason why I don't think she understood it, because, you know, you celebrating your birthday, so that it's this thing. And I think it's a stereotype that everybody has to be around on your birthday. You know, I don't really, you know, everybody got to be around for your birthday. And this is a crazy thing. Everybody wants to be around for your birthday, but do they do things for your birthday? Y'all get that? Or y'all don't get that? Simple. I'll give you an example, right? So, usually, when you're in your early 20s or something like that, you want to throw a birthday party, right? Yeah, I want to throw a birthday party. Usually, you want to throw a birthday party at the club, right? But when you throw that birthday party at the club, who's the one paying for the VIP? Who's the one paying for everything for the party? You are, because it's your birthday. But usually, nobody's really contributing, but everybody want to come, right? And enjoy the money that you spent on yourself, right? That's one thing, you know, I remember that in the 20s. A lot of people like, yeah, I'm throwing my birthday party at this club. Yeah, we're going to be over here. Come through. They spent money to have a good night out with their friends that didn't spend no money on them. I don't understand that. But, you know, as you get older, you start to understand these type of things. So, me, a lot of times I used to say, I want to be alone on my birthday. And I was like, why you want to be alone? You don't want to be around the family. You don't want to be around me. Is it me? Am I the problem? Or no, you just want that day alone to just think. Have you just had like a day to just, a whole day just to think? Is that troublesome? Is that dangerous? It can be if you're not mentally ready or got the mental capacity for that. But to be alone, to think about certain things in your life, right? Certain accomplishment, certain things you're proud of, certain things you're not proud of. It's like you're weighing out what you've done and what you haven't done, right? Or where you need to go and where you haven't been, you know? It's that time alone that actually on your birthday, you can write the next chapters of your life, right? You can do certain things without a lot of background noise that's influenced you, right? These are your creation. These are your ideas, right? These are your ideas that you're thinking. Like, I'm not being persuaded by my wife, or I'm not being persuaded by the kids. This is something that I want to do eventually. And there's nothing wrong with having these goals that you want to do, that you want to do by for yourself. You know, for yourself, basically. There's nothing wrong with that. And so that used to be a big thing for me several years back. I just be like, hey, she'd be like, where you want to go for your birthday? What do you want to do? Say, no, I just want to be alone. And she's like, that's it? Well, I'm just going to leave you alone. She give me that attitude. Like, I don't want to be around her. It's not that I don't want to be around her. Of course I want to be around her. I love her. I see you every day. You know what I'm saying? But it's my birthday. It's my day. If you ask me what I wish for my day, I just want to be alone. That's how I used to, you know, self-care for me. And it wasn't a depression or nothing like that. I wasn't sad about life or anything like that. I just wanted that day to put all my, you know, things that I've accomplished and everything that I, you know, goals that I set, and just, you know, reflect on me and evaluate myself. Does that make sense to y'all? I don't know if it makes sense to y'all, but that's how I wanted to be alone. So let me go on to the next one. Reading, right? Reading is a good self-care for us fellas. Reading is a great self-care for us fellas, right? And this is why I say that, right? Because when you start to read more and more, and even my wife noticed, not only that you expand your vocabulary, we all know that, but the way you go about life change, the way you start looking at life change. And when you start reading and you start talking to people about what you're reading, it's helping you and reteaching you everything that you just learned through reading, right? So I wasn't a big reader before I came across a lot of different companies where I seen reading. Well, I knew that reading was very important far as, what we call it, just far as, we call them IPAs, right? Income producing activities. Reading is very, very needed when you are in some type of business, or you're learning something about a new business or streams of income, or just a lifestyle that you want to live, right? To get to those things. So reading right there is another self-care that I think that we should take advantage of as fellas, and to learn more as even now, you know, get you a book that you can read at least about 10 pages a day, you know, and either start your day with it or end your day with it. If you can do it during lunchtime, that's cool. But I think you either start your day or you can end your day, and that'll set the tone for us men just going out into the world to be dealing with all this devilish or devils that we come across. You know what I mean? Because that's a real thing. Shopping. Shopping is a self-care. Now, that's a good self-care. And I think women love shopping too as well. And we got us fellas, we love to shop, you know, especially when the money's there. It's cool to shop there, you know what I mean? So, self-care. Me, I'm a watch guy. I like watches. You might got that cologne person, that person who like the colognes and the smells and stuff like that. That's cool. Then you have that person that like the shoes. I know we got a lot of shoe heads. I got a lot of shoe heads that's on Facebook and Instagram. They serious about their shoes. They Now they got a shoe show, like the car show. They got a shoe show where you bring your shoes and your most expensive shoes that you don't wear or you don't want in one time, or maybe not even worn one time, and you show off your shoes, right? You got shoe connoisseurs. Then we got racing, right? I put racing on there. That's a self-care for us fellas, because I just put racing because I put it more of a competitive thing. So it's not just racing, but it's more of a competitive thing of self-care. And I feel that's a self-care to let us know, like, when you're in a competitive ring as a man, to know where your level, where you stand, where you're at in life in this particular area that you're racing in or you're competing in. It's a good measuring stick to know where you at on certain competitive, and it don't have to be just physical, but it could be mental too as well. You know, you could play mental games that see where you at, you know. Number 9, eating is a self-care, right? So but I like that because usually us married men, we waiting on the wife to pick up what she want to eat, right? It's like, what do you want to eat? Whatever you want to eat. Then you pick something, then I'm not feeling that, right? Or she don't know what she want to eat, and so you riding around hungry because you don't know what she want to eat, and she's indecisive. So eating, I think that's the self-care for us, because I think when we are alone, when us fellas, we are alone, and we want to eat whatever we want to eat, we know the spot we want to go to, or if it's something that intrigues us, a new restaurant or new something, we look at like the ingredients and stuff like that. Like, oh, that sounds like it might taste pretty good. I'm gonna try that, you know. And I think that right there is more of like a self-care of just, you know, a relaxed mindset, eating whatever you want to eat, you know, and it's good on top of that, you know. I think that's the way we indulge in our self-care, and that right there is another thing that I could say that might be more physical than mental, right? Or it's a little bit of both, you know. Laughing. And I think laughing is in the top 5 of man's self-care. We gotta laugh, right? We gotta laugh no matter how stressed out we get throughout the day, throughout, you know, just life in general. A good comedy club, or just laughing, period, having something that's really funny. That right there is one of the top 5 things that us men, we have to invest in some type of laughter. We have to have something to laugh about throughout the day. It's got to be something that's funny, right? And that right there is just a mental release right there, right? Even though you're stressed, or you've been mad about something, or something's been on your mind, or you've been worried about something, I feel that laughter is a self-care for us. You know, it might be sometimes that, you know, I'm not even gonna lie. Sometimes, if you know Pandora, they got the comedians channel, right? And I ain't gonna lie, sometimes at work, if I need that self-care, or I'm stressed, or I'm not feeling the day or whatever, I'll go to Pandora and put on some of my favorite comedians while I'm at work and listen to them in my earbuds to have me laugh, to lighten up my day, to make me change my attitude. You know, something that I was going through, something that made me upset, something that just wasn't going right about my day. So, guys, take that hint right there. You going through something at work or something, that go to Pandora, find your favorite comedian. If they got them on there, put on a Pandora channel, listen to some of the jokes, or even listen to, even sometimes I listen to Nephew Tommy prank calls, right? I listen to that, right? And see, most women don't understand this right here. They don't understand that these are self-care. But when they come across of it, they might look at it as wasting time. You know, they might look at laughing or listening to something funny. It's wasting time. Like, you're just wasting time listening to jokes or whatever, you know. Or you're just wasting time listening to prank calls. They might find that way. But they don't understand that's a part of our self-care. Or when we go eating, right? You just was pigging out, right? It wasn't pigging out. I was just, you know, releasing. I wanted something good, whatever. You just wanted to eat without us. No, it's not that. It's self-care, you know? That's a self-care thing. Oh, babe, you've been at the gym 2 hours, right? I know you're not working out for 2 hours. Yeah, you can. You might not get all the physical aspects worked on in the 2 hours, but you can work out for 2 hours. You can be on the treadmill and run for about 45 minutes and then do your other lifting or whatever. You wasn't at the, and see, that might look like a stressful thing for a woman. They might say, you was at the gym for 2 hours. You got somebody up there that you like or somebody that you talking to. Nah, it was a stress reliever. I was up there and I had this spot, this time slot, these 2 hours that I know I could go work out and just get my thoughts together as a man, right? You've been out there working on that yard all day. You've been out there building on something all day. When you gonna come in the house and do this? Or when you gonna come in the house to do that? That's a self-care mechanism. So we gotta explain this stuff to our wives about self-care when they don't understand when we're doing something for a long period of time and they think that we're just messing around or we acting like we don't have nothing else to do. No, we have something else to do. And we know we got something else to do. We know we on the time limit on certain stuff. But when do we actually as men get that time for our self-care? Do you like tell your wife, and I know you don't, because I don't do it. Oh, babe, I need self-care time. No, I know you're not telling her that. I know you're not telling her that. I know I'm not telling my wife that. Hey, babe, I need some self-care time. You might need some time by yourself, but you ain't gonna tell her you need some self-care. Now, when it comes down to her, she gonna let you know off rip. This is self-care time. Don't interrupt. Don't call me. I'm doing my self-care thing. Us men, we too masculine for that, for one. But these are the things we do. And like, we might go to a lounge. And I get and see, what you was doing at the lounge? You was at the lounge? You said you was only gonna be there for 30 minutes. You've been there an hour. I was just having a good conversation with a dude at the bar about finances. Or he told me about some new finances that's coming out. I might want to look into it that can help us get some more money. Or we was talking about, we got to talking about religion, you know? And we got deep in it. Or we got to talking about sports, you know? And we had a sports bar. We got to talking about sports. We got to talking about what beers we like or where's a good place to go beers. Or we got to talk about he's from this state and I never been in that state and he told me things I could do with the family and the kids and stuff. But you stressing me over something that I call my self-care. I don't know. Am I wrong? No. You was at the concert. You went to the game. I went to the game because you don't like going to the games. So I went to the game. That was a self-care moment for me to just, I'm not at home. I'm not distracted by anybody that's around in the household. I'm at the game, watching the game, having a beer or whatever, watching the game, enjoying the game, right? You went to the game. The game starts at 7 o'clock. Why you got to be down there at 6 o'clock? I want to have all the activities of the game, like the pregame. I don't want to be there when everything just start popping off. I want to come in and be there before the game. I want to see the players warm up. I want them to warm up. I don't know what they do when they warm up. We don't get to watch that on TV. You know, what do they do? What are their rituals? You know, stuff like that, you know. And so this is why I feel that this conversation is really, you know, this is a real deep conversation, and I kind of kept it like that. And I played the Fabulous song for a reason. And it talks about how you can make me better, right? You can make me better. But he said certain things that I could do by myself, right? And certain things I could do by myself. But with you, you make me better. And if you allow me to take care of myself with these self-care attributes, and as long as the conversation is good, then we're going to be all right, right? We're going to be all right. And it's all about the communication, fellas. Now, when we do this, don't take advantage of it, you know, because then now trust is out the window. You know what I'm saying? Don't take advantage of your male self-care, because trust will then creep in, and it'll be, now she don't trust you, and you want to do your man's self-care, but she don't trust you because the last time you told her you was doing something, you wasn't doing what you said you was doing, or you went somewhere else, or you was just all out of balance with what you had going on. So when you discuss self-care with your wife, let her know how self-care can be, right? Self-care is different. For us men, self-care is more mental than physical, right? Because we physical all day, every day. You know what I'm saying? We physical all day, every day. So when it comes to self-care, it's more mental. It's not the pampering like a woman is, you know? Now, I go get a pedicure. Every so often, I go get a pedicure. It feels good. I get my feet done. Hey, I ain't got no problem with that. You know, it feels good to have somebody rub on your feet. You know what I'm saying? I ain't always going to be your wife. Feel good to have somebody rub on your feet, pay money, get your feet looking good, you know, and not have, you know, them critters everywhere when you go to the beach or something, you know, or when you walk around the house. Have them gators out. But at the same time, she is starting to understand my self-care now that we have this conversation. So, and this is the thing. When your wife start understanding your self-care, she'll actually start promoting self-care for you, right? She might be like, you might come in the house, and she can see it all on your face. She can see the attitude before you even come through the door. She already know it's been one of those days, right? And she might be like, you need to go to the gym or something. Release this. Like, not on me, but this tension you got to go to the gym. Or go outside and work on the yard. You know what I mean? And she might, like I said, she'll invite you to go do these self-care things. And when she do, take it. Take these moments that she might invite you to go do self-care. Like, especially like the working out. She's like, you need to go work out. Because your energy, and that's the thing about working out. When you go working out and you come back from working out, you ain't got that energy to argue. You don't got the energy to just, you know, to even, like, it is what it is. Like, you're not even really worried, you know? So, that's a good thing. She might say, you know, the way you kind of been just talking, like, you need to go, like, go back to reading that book you was reading. Because your mind state done, like, flip. Like, you ain't even... Like, when you was reading that book, you was all on this positive mindset, and now you done flipped to, like, I don't know who you are, right? Can you go back to reading another book, right? She might influence and encourage that, right? And those are good encouragement. Those are good things. And that's why I said, if any ladies on here, these are the things that you can do to encourage your husband to do his self-care things that he need to do, right? Because we need these self-care. Why don't you just go and watch the game and stuff like that? And see, I'm saying these things because these are things that my wife tell me, right? Good. Like this week, she was like, hey, go watch the game. I got the boys. You look like the week's been rough on you. Out of here, right? Things like that. Or she might catch me late at night when everybody's asleep watching a funny, Netflix movie or a funny stand-up on Netflix, and I'm laughing, right, to get me in a better mood. And she might not even like the comedian or anything, and she'll just let me watch that Netflix and won't bother me. Like, you know, she'll go back to doing what she was doing. She was like, he's in there, he's in a good mood. When you laugh and you're in a good mood, you know, stuff funny, right, you're in a good mood and stuff. So I just wanted to tell you fellas to figure out what your self-care mechanism is, figure out what you do for self-care, and pretty much communicate this with your wife, right? Because this is going to make it a lot easier for you to do those self-care things. And also, I put barbershop. Yeah, I know I need a haircut. I think I'm about to start cutting my own hair, though. Barbershop. And barbershop is a way we pamper ourselves, you know, far as men. But it's not too many things that we're going to do to pamper ourselves for self-care. It's more of, you know, and just be alone. And you know what? This goes back to if old school, like if they got that shed or they got the man cave. The man cave is deeper than just the man cave. A man cave is that time to, you know, kind of get the worries of the world off for you. That space in the house, that shed out back where you can be alone and get your thoughts together, right? And when you do that and you get your thoughts together, you can come back and be a better man, a better husband, a better father, right? So guys, thank y'all for tuning in today on this Monday. I wanted to get y'all week started off together, started off right, fellas. Thank y'all for tuning in. I hope this has been very helpful for you guys that are in a relationship with your wives and stuff like that. I hope even if you're just in a regular relationship and you're intending to get married, these are things you got to start doing before you get married. You start setting the tone before you get married instead of waiting till you get married. And now everything's, you're a different person all of a sudden. Now let's start working these tools and stuff before you get married, so then when you get married, she already know what it is. So again, we're launching our empowerment marriage program. We're going to launch that May 15th. We already got it up on Instagram. You can actually go to direct.me/BarkerWorldwide. You can check out our page. Go to our YouTube, like and subscribe. Hit the like and subscribe button. I'll be posting that back up. You got to catch this out, right? What else we got? Again, follow us on Marriage Porn on Instagram. It's marriage.p.o.r.n. Again, if you don't understand what it is, this is for pure, open, renew, and navigate. And babe, do you got the shirts? All right, we also got some merch too on the way. Hold on. So just so y'all know that this is for real, we got some merch right here. Y'all see it? Barker Worldwide. We got the marriage porn right there. So y'all see it? Pure, open, renew. Navigate. Got the front right here. Logo. Check that out. We got that right there. So yeah, we're going to come up with the merch on the actual site coming up. We'll probably have mugs, pens, all type of stuff like that for you guys to just, you know, workbooks to take notes and stuff like that. But again, thank you guys for tuning in. I hope y'all had a blessed Monday so far. And I hope y'all have a blessed rest of the week, fellas. Hey, it's up to us, fellas, to be the head of the household, to be the man, to be the leader in the house. We got to do what we got to do. Let's do it right. And I'll see y'all on Wednesday. When me and my wife are going to be on for our actual marriage together. We're going to do a group. We didn't do last week. Why didn't we do last week? We was, what was it doing?
Oh, we did do.
Oh no, we had.
I had my house on.
Yeah, we had a lot of things going on. I had a passing in the family. You know, I forgot about that. We had a passing in the family, so we had a lot going on last Wednesday. So that's why y'all didn't catch us last Wednesday. But we for sure will be on this Wednesday. Y'all lock and load. Get your wives on, fellas. You know, get your wives on. And y'all cool to chime in. We're going to get something juicy to talk about where we can go back and forth. You know, maybe do a men's versus women. And also, we got a book. We got a book that we're going to start going over. And this is going to be one of them, like, one of them sexy, juicy books that we're going to go into chapter by chapter. This is one of those books that's a relationship with Christians with slash 50 Shades of Grey type stuff going on in it, right? You know what I mean? On the marriage tip side of things. But again, thank y'all for tuning in. And again, see y'all Wednesday. Peace.